Hi guys, welcome to C2C, and I have been reading your comments, so please do engage. And based on the comments, what I'll start doing from oh, by the way, I'll be solving the fourth verbal TCY ka fourth mock. So in the comment section, some of a lot of y'all have mentioned that accuracy dikha do, final result kya hai wo dikha do. So that's something that I'll do by the end of the paper. That's number one. Number two is in one of the papers, I think one of the sections, I had only say 6 to 7 minutes for BA. Now that was the case because the passages, all four of them, were quite difficult to read. Okay, so that's why उधर राश मेरा rationing सही नहीं था, उधर थोड़ा सा और 2 मिनट होना चाहिए था ideally, because I think you'll remember that I had to rush through last two PJs. And that set had like one summary, one OOO, and four PJs, right? So I should have rationed a little better. Had there been more summaries, since it's my forte, I could have then taken that risk. So that is something that I would have changed. And other than that, even the people who are disliking the videos, just let us know what the reason are. And some of you all mentioned that itna baat mat karo, or don't give us explanation. Just, do your paper. We want to see how you attempt. I believe that that could work for some people, but a lot of the times, since you will be there sitting down with your thoughts and your decision-making ability, so me actually discussing the questions and options while it goes on is somewhat, I think it helps you all a little more, and that's why I do try to cover that. And if that is something that still is not necessary, then do let us know. I will strictly solve the paper from the next one onwards if you want it to be like that. So that can be availed. That's definitely not a problem. I think I'll be just faster, thoda sa. Okay. That being said, it's already 2 minutes, 10 seconds, 11 seconds now. So let's begin. Yes. We have our notepad ready too. There it is. And yeah, let's jump on it. Oh, by the way, guys, even for these sections that I'm giving, right, I make sure that the time same. Okay, so it's something similar. Starting, so let's check 7th pe, the trend. Okay, there you go. 7th pe se my first, this is there. So let's check at 11. That's like what, 5 questions? Okay, I think, one second. Yeah, so is the questions are the same, right? Okay, 12th may change order. 7 to 11 is our set. Okay, there are 5 Qs. Okay, let's look at what the set is talking about. Thanks. The mind may be likened to a great sea upon which there are visible a few islands. The islands represent the conscious thoughts that consciousness we might call. Okay, mind and philosophy. The language of this is not very enticing, so let's see. Following phrases denote the expression, the mind be likened to a great sea upon which. Okay. Seventh could be a category which is a central point of the author trying to make. No. What is it that the baby is making it personal? Okay, so 9, 7 and 9. Following can be inferred. No. Organization of the passages. 7 and 9. 7, 9. Let's categorize 11 also, but just put brackets because it somewhat is summary type. Okay, so let's go on to 12. Say, thanks to the investigation of physiologists and psychologists, usually combined in person of a physician, a nervousness has been found to be not an organic disease but a functional one. Oh, I like this topic. It's a good one, right? So 12th से कहाँ तक है? 12th we have seen. Let's check till 16. 16 5 question तो है. Let's check 17. There you go. So we have 5 questions over here. Okay. So 12 to 16, 5 questions. Nervousness. Good topic, right? Passages organized in the following manner, similar to if we are going to consider that, that this also, right? The most pertinent question that the author tries to answer is no, definitely not. Primary concern of the passage, no. Following can be inferred from the passage, no. What does the author mean by stating the brain is really acting up? Okay, maybe somewhat objective, so I'll keep this. I like the topic though. I like what it's talking about. But let's see towards the end kya karna hai. It is evident that in what is called the evolution of animal form, the foot came in suddenly when the backbone creatures began to live. Oh, wow. That's also a good one. And let us note that the art of standing, the importance of feet, if I may, right? So let's check till 21 if the questions remain the same. The passage, yeah, the passage is the same. Let's see it. Okay, so at 22 it changes. So 17 to 21. 21. So there are what? Again, five questions are there. So this is importance of feet. Or inception of. Anyway, in the passage, the author basically discusses. Okay. Saransh pucha hai. The style of the passage cannot be faulted on all of the following grounds except, okay, style of the passage cannot be faulted. It's a little too convoluted for my taste. Which of the following inferences cannot be drawn from the above selection? Negative mein inference based. Good. Talk about layers. What price did the winged bird have to pay? Very good. 20 is definitely directly an objective. Most objective abhi tak jo bhi hai and the only one rather. So, I would say this is 20. Okay, then we have 22. To 25, there are 4 questions and what is the set about? What is the set about? There can be no sane discussion of crime and guilt without an investigation of the meaning of the words. A large majority of men, even among the speak of a criminal as if the word had a clearly defined meaning. Okay, etymology? Criminal? Maybe? So, meaning of criminal word. I would have gone for etymology, but theek hai, dekhte hai. It might not be about etymology. It could be about the psychology of a criminal. Why does the author believe that the punishment follows for the violation of laws and not for moral transgression? Okay, fair enough. Why does the author state the word criminal doesn't have a clearly defined meaning? Okay, scope is narrower. In what way does the author use the phrase judging from the kind of men sent? Okay, say, okay, theek hai. So, 22nd, 23rd, I felt to be objective. Rest we'll see. Okay, so mind and philosophy definitely had more objective questions, but I'll still start with nervousness. Why? Because the topic was better, and if I had to choose between the two, then definitely this fits in better. Then we'll go with importance of feet. I really liked importance of feet too, but then the questions are too subjective for my taste, right? And then we'll go towards the end for a relatively simpler set. ठीक है, लेट्स लुक एट टॉप में क्या चल रहा है. ओके, वन पीजे 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 पीजे, वाओ सो मेनी. फोर पीजे समरी, फिफ्थ सिक्स, ओ ओ ओके, लेट्स पुट इट ओवर हियर. सो पीजे समरी, okay, so 1 2 3 4, this is 5, this is 6, done. Okay, let's begin 12 to 16. There you go. Okay, that's the investigation of physiological psychology combined in person of a physician. Nervousness has been found to be not an organic disease but a functional one. Okay, this is very important distinction. For an organic disease implies impairment of the tissue of the organ, while functional disorder means only a disturbance of its action. Okay, in a purely nervous disorder, there seems to be no trouble with what the nerves and organs are, but only with what they do. It is behavior and not tissues that is at fault. Of course, in real life, things are seldom as clear-cut as they look are in books. And so it happens that often there is a combination of organic functional disease that is puzzling even to a skilled diagnostician. The first essential is a diagnosis to whether it is an organic disease with accompanying nervous system symptoms or a functional disturbance complicated by some minor organic trouble. If the main cause is organic, okay, the main cause, only physical means can cure it. But if the trouble is functional, no amount of medicine or surgery, diet or rest will touch it. Yet the symptoms are so similar and the dividing line is so elusive that great skill is sometimes required to determine whether given symptom points to be a disturbance of physical tissue or only to behavior. Okay, fair enough. If the physician is sometimes fooled, how much more the sufferer himself sometimes fool how much more the sufferer himself. Nausea from a healthy stomach is just as sickening as nausea from the diseased one, right? A fainting smell is equally uncomfortable whether it comes from an impaired heart or simply from one that is behaving badly for the moment. It must be remembered that in a functional nervousness, the trouble is very real. The organs are really acting up. It is the brain that may be instead of stomach or heart. In that case, it often reports all kinds of pains that have no origin outside of the brain. Pain, of course, is perceived only by the brain. Okay, pain is perceived by the brain. Cut the telegraph wire, the nerve, and no amount of injury to finger can cause pain. It is equally true that, okay, a misbehaving brain can report sensations that have no external cause, that have not come in through the regular channel along the nerve. The pain feels just the same. Is every bit as uncomfortable as though its cause were external. Okay, sometimes instead of that's a bad sentence. Sometimes instead of reporting false pain, the brain misbehaves in other ways. Okay, seems to lose its power to decide, to concentrate, or to remember. Then the patient is almost sure to fancy himself going insane. Wow, but insanity is a physical disease. Okay, implying changes or toxins in the brain cell. Functional disorders tell another story. Their core is different, even though it went into circle now. Even though this picture they present is often a close copy of an organic disease, it should not be thought, however, that symptoms of functional organic troubles are identical. Hysteria and neurasthenia closely simulate every imaginable physical disease, but they do not exactly parallel any one of them. It may take a skilled eye to discover the difference, but differences are there. Functional troubles usually show a near picture of organic disease with just enough tell another the cause different symptoms. Okay, hysteria ye ho gaya. Functional troubles usually show a near picture of organic disease with just enough contradiction or inconsistent features to furnish a clue to their real nature. For this reason, it is important that the treatment of the disease be solely the province of physician, for only the carefully trained in all the requirements of diagnosis can differentiate the pseudo from real and the innocuous from the disastrous. Also, nervous neuritis may feel like real neuritis, result of poison in the blood, but it gives itself away when it localizes itself in part of the body where there is no nerve trunk. Okay, the exhaustion of neurasthenia sometimes seems extreme enough to be the result of a dangerous physical event, but when this exhaustion disappears as if by magic under the proper kind of treatment, we know that the trouble cannot be in the body. Let it be said then, with all the emphasis we can command, nerves are not physical. Lab investigation, contradictory symptoms, and response to treatment all bear witness to this fact. Okay, whatever symptoms of disturbance there may be in pure nervousness, the nerves and organs can in no way be shown to be diseased. Okay, fair enough. Now, this is 12 to 16, right? 12 to 16, 12, 16, and 12, 16. 12 to 16 only, 12 and 16 we need to do. Okay, okay. So the passage is organized in the following manner. The passage considers two sides of the controversy and recommends a pragmatic approach. Two sides of the, there's no controversy. Not a controversy. Right? The passage differentiates between two orientations of a malady and suggests a discerning approach. Okay, B, more correct definitely than A. The passage uses empirical evidence to make a point. Not using empirical evidence to make a point. Differentiating, yeah, this is more correct than C also. Delineates the functional aspects of pathological symptoms and recommends seeking of expert opinion. This is thing one, so I'm going with that. 15, 16, take that. What does the author mean by stating that brain is really acting up? The problem is neither neurological nor organic. Okay, the problem may be neurological as well as organic. The problem is purely neurological. The problem may be more neurological and less organic, right? So when he's saying brain is really acting up, tabi he means that the problem is the latter, it's not the physical one, right? Jaisa for organic disease, right? It's not organic, right? That's what they're saying, it's a functional one. So this C makes more sense, right? Because yahan pe they may be neurological as well as organic bol rahe, right? So that's not true. It's neurological, it's not organic, and that's exactly what we are talking about. The brain is really acting up, the organs are really acting up. There you go. Right. Go with this. Okay, let's look at the others. This is a little frustrating, especially when हाँ देखो देखो राइट, द मोस्ट पर्टिनेंट क्वेश्चन दैट ऑथर ट्राइज टू आंसर इज व्हाई इज इट इम्पोर्टेंट डायग्नोज अ केस टू असेस इफ द प्रॉब्लम इज फंक्शनल और ऑर्गेनिक. ओके, व्हाट इज द लिंक बिटवीन फंक्शनल ऑर्गेनिक डिजीज? नो ही इज नॉट डूइंग दैट, आई एम नॉट फुल्ली कन्विंस्ड ऑन इट. व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन फंक्शनल एंड ऑर्गेनिक डिजीज? नो एक्चुअली या उसने बोला था ऊपर की द डिसर्निंग द डिफरेंस टुवर्ड्स द एंड ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हाई इट बिकम्स इंपॉर्टेंट टू डिसर्न द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू. सो दैट्स व्हाई ए, या ए कुड बी इट. व्हाई आर सिम्टम्स ऑफ बोथ ऑर्गेनिक एंड फंक्शनल डिजीज वेरी सिमिलर? नो नॉट व्हाई आर, ये तो डिस्कस नहीं हो रहा है. आई एम कंफ्यूज बिटवीन ए एंड सी, बट दिस ही हैज स्पेसिफिकली मेंशन आई थिंक, सो आई एम डेफिनेटली गोइंग विद दैट. फॉर दिस रीजन इम्पॉर्टेंट द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ द रीजन ऑल द रिक्वायरमेंट कैन डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन द इनऑक्यूस. बट या दैट्स व्हाई. That's also there. Let's look at 14. The primary concern of the passage is to explain the importance of research in understanding neurological problem, either functional or organic. No, that's it's not emphasizing on primary importance of research. Emphasize the importance of delinking neurological problem from organic disturbances. Yes. Okay. B is more correct. To emphasize the importance of a skilled diagnostician. Important skill diagnosis and assessing if the problem is functional. That's not the primary concern. It is important, but that's not the primary thing that they're talking about. To explain why is it important, it is most important to understand symptoms before beginning the treatment. Okay. No, this should be better because delinking mein pata tha, even in neurothemia, I think they were talking about how localized a particular pain ho sakta even with respect to poison. So, yeah, but I'll mark this for review. If I get time, I'll come back on it again. Okay, let's take the last question. Which the following can be inferred from the passage except disease may not be found to be totally functional or related to the physical but may have a degree of both. Okay. Yes, the degree of complexity in treatment of a functional disease is higher than in an organic one. Yes, that health status of a person is a function of both his neurological and organic health. That's true. The diagnostician should first of all assess if the problem is neurological or functional before beginning the treatment, as the right diagnosis is the key to the right treatment. Okay. None of them seem to be not, honestly, this is a little difficult. I'll just mark for review. I don't have time to waste, so let's move on. What is the second set that we were going to take? Second set was the first one, so let's take that. And 12 to 16 done. First one is at 7, right? I'll just expand this thoda sa, so that everything 7 to 11. There you go. Where is it? 7. There you go. The mind may be likened to a great sea upon which there are visible a few islands. The islands, conscious thought, that consciousness we use to calculate, to map out our plans, to form our judgment. This is the mind that for centuries was accepted as the entire mind. But we know that the islands are merely the top of the huge mountain ranges formed by the floor of the sea, mighty permanent upheaval. Whereas the sea floor rises high above its customary levels and thrusts its bulk above the waters into the atmosphere, it is possibly the island. Just so, there can be no consciousness except as that which is already in the mind. The vast subconscious material of all the experience rises into view and relates itself through the senses to an outset. So, our recognition of the impression is merely the rising into consciousness. Rising of the subconscious material in response to a stimulus from the outside world which appeals through the senses. Such a good article. Yeah, the visible island is but a symbol. The visible island is but a symbol of the submarine mountain. The present mental impression is but proof of a great bulk of past experiences. Okay. Great bulk of, one second. Huh. And so we might carry on the figure and compare the birth of consciousness to the instant of appearance of the mountaintop above the water surfaces. It is not a new bit of land. It is only emerging into a new world. A new bit of, okay. The island and the submarine mountain are different things. Okay. The sea floor is transformed when it enters into a new element. Into the new element. The sea floor into the new element. An entirely different vegetation takes place on this visible island that took place on the floor of the sea before it emerged. Okay, now the metaphor is they're stretching the metaphor. An entirely different vegetation takes place on this visible island, then took place on the floor. Okay, but the only new element added to the hitherto submerged land come from new atmosphere, and the seafloor immediately begins to become a new different thing, very different thing. Nevertheless, what it is as an island is now and forever will be due primarily to its structure as a submarine mountain. Okay, in the new atmosphere, the soil is changed, new chemical elements enter in, seeds are brought to it by the four winds, and it is changed, but it is still the seafloor, transformed. Just so the baby brain is primarily and in its elements, and the brain evolved through thousands of centuries of pushing up to man's level through the sea of animal life, and hundreds of centuries more of the development of man's brain to its present complete mechanism through experience with constantly changing environment. Hence, when the baby sees light and responds by tightly shutting his eyes and later by opening them to investigate his sensation, what it is, because through the eons of the past man has established a certain relation to light through experiencing it. So our baby soon shows certain instinctive reaction. He reaches out to grasp, he sucks, he cries, he looks at the light and bright objects in preference to dark. He is carrying out the history of his race but is making it personal. Has evolved a new life, but all his ancestors make his foundation. The personal element added to his heritage has made him different from any kind of all his forebearers. But he can have no consciousness except as a bit from the vast inherited accumulation of the past of his ancestors of the entire race steps forth to meet a new environment. How came the first consciousness? It is as far back as the first created or evolved organism which could respond in any way to a material world. And only metaphysics and God behind metaphysics can say. Experiments on the unconscious today prove that our conscious life is what it is because of first what is stored away in unconscious, second because of what we have accepted from our environment, and this comprises our material, intellectual, social, spiritual environment. Okay, fair enough. So let's look at what hai. Thoda sa complicated hai. Beech mein I did lose my track. Let's see. We'll figure out 7, 9 and 11. Okay, let's look at 7. Which of the following phrases denote the expression the mind may be likened to a great sea? Okay, the sea is the mind and the islands are subconscious mind. No, island denote the conscious mind and the sea is the subconscious mind. No, island rises above the sea but have their base in the form of a mountain. Okay, but that is not what this is talking about. The sea represents the mind, island is the sea, other conscious thoughts, and jo niche hai wo subconscious hai. This is very, I'm so proud of this particular question. Why I chose this? It was so easy. 7th wala mark hua. Arre. There you go. Okay, let's go on to the 9th one. What is it that the baby is making it personal? The experiences, the conscious mind, the software of the brain. This is definitely out. Experiences also no. It has to be conscious mind, but also it has this is correct, but this is more correct because it also encompasses the subconscious mind, because subconscious ke andar past ka sab aa chuka hai, right? So I'll take that one, and we'll take the 11th one. Okay, till now no question to throw me off. The organization of the passage is presentation of evidence supporting a viewpoint, 20 minutes. Okay, explaining a philosophical tenet, a presentation of evidence supporting a viewpoint, explaining a physical tenet, giving scientific proof to support a supposition, offering a parallel to explain a phenomena. Okay, yeah, evidence supporting a viewpoint. Okay, ये नहीं है, scientific proof नहीं है, because that's not what he's doing. Explain philosophical tenet, no. I think this, because offering a parallel to explain a phenomena, he's giving example. That's what this thing is saying, थोड़ा सा convoluted way में, ठीक है? That's why I'm choosing that. Let's move on. 7 to 11 था, so 10 बचा है and 8 बचा है. Let's look at 8. Which of the following is central point that the author is trying to make? Our senses are the link between the mind and our environment. Subconscious mind is the master and conscious mind the slave. Subconscious mind and environment are the detriments of the conscious mind. Determinants of the conscious mind. Subconscious and the this now makes sense. Yes. Yeah. Determinants of the conscious mind. Yeah, yeah. Basically, वही बोल रहा है कि जो ऊपर का island है वो नीचे से ही आ रहा है. Right. That's exactly what they are saying. That's done. 9 is done. let's go on to the 10th one, right? The following can be inferred from the passage except baby's brain changes according to the environment in which he lives. Yes. Our brains are programmed from the dawn of time. Yes. The conscious mind is only a small part of the whole mind. Okay. Which is subconscious. Fair enough. The structure of our brain has changed since hundreds and thousands of years. Nothing is talked about the structure of the brain. They've talked about how we are forming conscious and subconscious, and I don't think this can be inferred. Okay. So this is done. Let's look onto the third one, 17 to 21. Fair. Chalo. Let's try to wrap this up as quickly. We are running short of time, so I'll be talking lesser, even lesser. It is a thing that is called the cookies and the features and the flowers, how it came, and it is a question which still puzzles the who cannot find a short pedigree for the frog. There is anyhow a remarkable point about it, that the foot of a frog is not a rudimentary thing but an authentic standard foot, like the yard measure kept in a town and of which all the other feet as an actual instrument is part of the original outfit given to the finders of the brainy backbone and foot races when they were sent out to multiply and replenish the earth is surely worth considering. Well, it consists essentially of a sole or palm made up of small bones and of five separate digits, each with several joints. In the hind foot of a frog, the toes are very long and webbed from point to point. In this, it differs a good deal from the toad, and there is significance in the difference of heavy gated toad satisfied with sour ants, hard beetles, and can keep pick easily and grow nasty and consequently so that nothing seeks to eat it, has hobbled through life like a the more versatile and nimble with it, seeking better diet, greater security, and went back to the element in which it was bred and swimming, much became better fitted for swimming. The soft elastic skin between the fingers or toes is just the soft tissue which responds most readily to inward impulses, and we find that the very same change has come about in those birds and bees which live much in water. I know that this is not the acceptable theory of evolution, but I'm waiting till it shall become so. We are developed in the direction of our tendencies and shall, I doubt not, be wise enough someday to give animals leave to do same. Okay. Action of a tendency, right. Right. When we pass from reptiles to birds, an astounding thing has happened, that there were flying reptiles in the fossil age. We know, and there are flying beasts in our own, but the wings of these are simple mechanical alteration which the immigration of a child or savage could explain. The hands of a bat are hands still, and though the fingers are hampered by the awkward glove, the thumbs are free. The giant fruit bats of tropic, okay. Quite acrobatically with the thumb and feet. Here is the whole subkingdom, as they call it, of the animal world, which has unreservedly and irrevocably bartered one pair of its limbs in the time that the apparatus is made of feathers and you mentioned and known to amphibian or saurian. The price was heavy. The bird must get through life with one pair of feet and its mouth. And let us note that the art of standing began with birds. Frogs sit, and as far as I know, every reptile we raise its body on the ground when we carrying it, and these have each four fat legs. Contrast the flamingo, only two, and those with below. Note also that one toe has been altogether discarded by birds as superfluous. The germ or bud must be there, for the dorking fowl has produced a fifth toe under which some influence of the poultry art, but no natural bird has more than four, except in swifts, which never perch but cling to the rocks and walls. One turns backwards, and like contrivance, the act of bending the leg draws them all automatically together. So the hen closes its toes at every step it takes as it grasps something, and of course when it settles down on its roost, they grasp the tight and hold it fast till morning. But to birds that do not perch, this mechanism is only an encumbrance. So many of them, like the plovers, abolish the hind toe entirely, and prince of all two-legged runners, the ostrich has got rid of one of the front toes, also retaining only two. Great, great, really enjoyed this. Let's look at the question fatafat. Only 20th is this, so let's just go in the order only. Now, the author basically did the evolution of reptiles and birds in front of the overall idea of how frogs and toes are woke up. The importance of development of feet for frogs and birds. Okay, evolution of organs of movement within the animal kingdom as a whole, with special reference to frog. There you go, easy peasy. Yeah. The style of the passage cannot be faulted on all of the following grounds, except cannot be faulted, okay, except it does not exemplify the ideas presented, okay, it is full of too many details, faulted on all of the following except, okay, it is littered with jargon, is not littered with jargon. They know there's barely any jargon, right? So, can be faulted, cannot be faulted and all. It does go get into too many details, so I'll go with two, only two. Okay, and we have 19th now. 19th का क्या रहेगा? Which of the following inferences cannot be drawn from the above selection? The author's idea about the development of soft tissues on feet of the bird is open to question. Author's idea about the development of soft tissues on feet of the bird is open to question. The toad is rarely eaten, if at all, by predators. The frog's original home at the time of birth was the water bodies. And from the okay, this is fine. Toad is rarely eaten, if at all, this is fine. Idea, so 2 and 3 are fine. The author's idea about development of soft tissue on feet of the bird is open to question. Okay, all of them should be valid, but I'll just mark for review and move on to next. I do not know about that. What price did the winged bird have to pay for flying free into the high skies? Okay, toes का कुछ सीन होना चाहिए, राइट इसमें? Their feet remained rudimentary. They had to make do with just a pair of feet. हाँ, right. उसने बोला कि standing started with them. Okay. फीट रिमेन रुडिमेंट्री, नो ये नहीं है. दे कुड नॉट डेवलप अ स्ट्रॉन्ग बैकबोन, ये कहीं से भी नहीं आया. दे कुड नॉट ले देयर बॉडी ऑन द ग्राउंड टू रिलैक्स, नो. दिस इज सही है, सही है. द टोन ऑफ द पैसेज इज सरमाइजिंग, एक्सप्लेनेटरी, डिस्क्रिप्टिव, एवोल्यूशनरी. ओके, दिस इज अ लिटिल डिफिकल्ट. लेट्स मार्क दिस फॉर रिव्यू एंड ट्राई टू आंसर द प्रीवियस वन, बिकॉज दिस आई वोंट बी एबल टू आंसर. 19th वाला ट्राई करते हैं. The author's idea about the development of soft tissue on feet of the bird is open to question. Honestly, he does do, like it could be this. And its mouth began. Right, he is speculating, right? So yes, it's open to question. He is speculating because I read the tone of the passage and he is speculating in a lot of them. It's 12 minutes, so let's try to wrap the last passage in 4 minutes or so. Okay, there can be no sane discussion of crime and criminal without investigation of the meaning of the word. A large majority of the men, even strong defined as a matter of fact, there is no such division, and from the nature of things, there can never be such a line. Strictly speaking, a crime is forbidden by the law of the land, and one which is considered sufficiently serious to warrant providing penalties for its commission does not necessarily follow that this act is either good or bad. If the punishment follows for the violation of the law and not necessary for the moral transgression, no doubt most of the things forbidden by the penal code are such as injurious to the organized society and are usually of such character. Right, but even then, it does not take not always follow the that the violator of the law is not a person of higher type. The majority who are directly and indirectly responsible for the law, it's apparent that a thing is not necessarily bad because it is forbidden by law. Legislators are forever repealing and abolishing criminal status, exactly, statutes. An organized society is constantly ignoring laws until they fall into the disuse and die. The laws against witchcraft, the long line of blue laws, and laws against affected beliefs and many social customs are well known examples of legal and innocent acts which legislatures and courts had once made criminal. Not only are criminal statutes always dying by repeal or repeated violation, but every time a legislature meets, it changes penalties for existing crimes and make criminal certain acts that were not forbidden before. Judging from the kind of men sent to state legislature and the central legislative body, the fact that certain things are forbidden does not mean that these things are necessarily evil, but rather politicians believe that there is a demand for such much from the class of society that is most powerful in the political action. No one who examined the question satisfied that a thing intrinsically wrong forbidden by a legislative body. ठीक है, fair enough. Let's go on. What is the central idea of the passage? The ruling class of the people with power decide the law. No, morality and crime are two different things, and crime cannot be said to be amoral because the basis of the criminal statute is not morality. Okay, B maybe crime cannot be demarcated into good or bad or right or wrong. It depends on the belief of the society prevalent at that time. This is more correct than this one. The basis of criminal statute is not morality. Yeah, this is more correct. Prevalent at that time. That are forbidden are not necessarily evil and don't demand a punishment for the same. It depends on more on the. No, that is more correct, more better structure. Why does the author believe that the punishment follows punishment violation of law and not the moral transgression? Okay, the criminal act may be good or bad in itself. Fair. Moral laws should not be binding on the people. No, be absolutely not. The violation is of utmost consequence and morality is secondary. No, लीगैलिटी एंड मोरालिटी डोंट गो हैंड इन हैंड. ओके, ह्यूमन एक्ट मे बी गुड और बैड इन इटसेल्फ. आई एम एक्चुअली कंफ्यूज बिटवीन ई एंड डी, बट आई गो विथ ए. माई माई चॉइस वुड बी ए बिकॉज ए कवर्स दिस कुड बी इंटरप्रेटेड इन मल्टीपल वेज, बट दिस हैज अ मोर डायरेक्ट मीनिंग, सो दैट्स व्हाई आई एम मार्किंग दैट. ओके, व्हाई डज द ऑथर स्टेट दैट द वर्ड क्रिमिनल डजंट हैव अ क्लियरली डिफाइंड मीनिंग. मैन कैनॉट बी डिवाइडेड बाई डिस्टिंक्ट लाइन इन टू क्रिमिनल एंड द वर्चुअस एज द लॉज आर डिफरेंट फॉर डिफरेंट प्लेसेज एंड टाइम्स. क्रिमिनल कैनॉट बी डिफाइंड. As the laws are different for different places and times, criminals cannot be defined. No, this is not true. Legislators are forever repealing and abolishing criminal statutes, so there is no fixed definition of a criminal. Now, a clearly defined meaning cannot be defined by, say, okay. And the virtuous, okay. It is amoral to label anybody a criminal. D nahi hai. A and C ke beech mein confusion hai. Forever repealing. But that's not the reason. This is the reason, right? Cannot be divided into criminal and virtuous. That's not a two oranges. That's why it's not either or. In what context does the author use the phrase judging from the kind of men sent to the state legislature and central legislative body? The moral character of people sent to the legislature nowadays, the political overtones of the terms crime and criminal, the belief system of the bulk of legislators. And men sent to the state legislature, the belief system of the bulk of legislators. Okay. I'm not too sure about this, and I will just mark this for review. So how many are we leaving then? 1, 2, 3. We have left 3, right? And 3 mark for review. 3, I think I can make do with 3. Let's just go for this now. One of the ways to success is affirmation in the form of chanting, and that has been practiced by most of the successful people on this planet. Inspirational writer Robin Sharma says, mastery manual, a regular affirmation of chant of your choice is a highly effective tool. Program and re-script your breath. The chant in his words could be something like this: I am an elite performer, seeing changes as an opportunity and having fun while I create success. Of course, you have to bear in mind that there is no alternative to hard work and determination. Factors like chanting could be good supplements. Okay. Chanting enhances creativity. No, chanting is a way of being present in the moment. No, success is assured if one keeps on chanting as an alternative to hard. No, chanting as affirmation can help you believe that you can succeed. There you go. We have a winner, and this was very simple. The summary was very simple. Let's look at OOO now. Yeah, OOO. Okay. Cute cues include behavior that appear helpless, harmless, charming, and yielding, and anatomical features such as outsized heads. Okay. As we move toward the uncanny end, sweet qualities and distorted into something darker, more indeterminate, and more wounded. Okay. The craze for all things cute is motivated most obviously by the urge to escape from precisely a threatening world into a garden of innocence in which childlike qualities arouse. Perhaps, okay, as we move to uncanny end, sweet qualities get discerned into something darker, more wounded. This horror of animal, okay, our response to these sort of cues to motivate us to give our offspring the care and nurture that they can. Okay, cute cues include behavior that appear helpless, harmless, charming, and healing. Okay, according to Lawrence, the same visual cues can arouse us to equally intense or possibly more intense caregiving when we encounter them in exaggerated distant form. This is the second one is just random, right? These cues sort of they're talking about cute. This is just bringing a very dark sense to it, and that's why I'm going to go with that. Right, this is talking about cuteness. This is talking about as we move towards the uncanny and sweet qualities. What sweet qualities get distorted? Something no, it just goes out for this reason. For this reason, I feel we are beginning an interesting cultural period which will be characterized by a long patient struggle. Okay, this is the time for cultural dialogue for discovering the spiritual concept. Okay, in this respect, we realize that each language is a universe full of enigmas. Okay, we are coming to the end of the 20th century with the certainty that no one culture has a monopoly on knowledge, values, or art of living, or the art of living. So, 4 se start hoga. Interesting. Okay, yeah, so now we are talking about this, then this period thing ties in, right? So this should be the period thing ties in. Then period ke upar thoda sa they are expanding, right? This is the time for intellectual, intercultural dialogue. So that's why two comes and then bacha teen hai. Chal. This is my. So very first thing I'm doing is trying to identify which the lead could be, right? Isme paanch hai. Paanch hai. Isme chaar hai. Let's do this. Theek hai? Repeat. Led to relative lull in colonial agitation for a few years, though even this lull was disturbed by Boston Massacre and other incidents. Okay. The universal resistance to the acceptance of this tea was dramatized by Boston Tea Party, which provoked the Boston Port Act and other intolerable acts of the spring of 1774. The attempt of Parliament to bail the vast East India companies out of its financial difficulties by giving its tea a privileged position in the American market reopened old issues that had been set aside by but never resolved. Okay, this is a little difficult, man. The crisis now has entered a new phase. Now the colonists felt their rights and liberties were being invaded in many ways. Okay, theek hai. Repeat in 1770. This tea was dramatized by which broke the Boston Tea Party and other the crisis now entered a new phase. Now the colonists felt their rights and liberties were invaded in many ways. Okay, so 3 and 2 are forming what, you know, 3 and 2 are forming this arrangement. So 3 ke baad mein 2 to aa raha hai, theek hai? So I know now I need to figure out where 4 is coming, because it's a smaller line, so I can adjust that universal resistance. Okay, universal resistance. ओके सो टू के ओके सो थ्री एंड टू एक ऑर्डर फॉर्म कर रहा है. नाउ टू को फॉलो करता हुआ वन तो नहीं है. वन इज नॉट फॉलोइंग इट. वन रादर सीम्स टू बी द फर्स्ट सेंटेंस. टू को फॉलो करता हुआ फोर है, ठीक है. सो माय अरेंजमेंट विल बी 1 3 2 4, ठीक है. 1 3 2 4, दैट्स व्हाई, ठीक है. लेट्स ट्राई टू अटेम्प्ट वन मोर प्रॉपरली एंड लेट्स सी कि कितना बचेगा. ठीक है. Okay, let's do this, ठीक है. Also because the goods will be delivered more, no, separate activities or function, all of which fall under a business firm's logistics umbrella, include customer service, demand forecasting, documentation flow, inventory management, this activities. Okay, 2, 3 definitely आ रहा है. Activities must be planned and executed in coordination with each other. The logistics manager may pay more for one element of service in order to save an even larger amount on a different element. For example, air freight. Okay, 4 and 5 is following the logic. Also, because the goods will be delivered more quickly, payment for them is received more quickly. Okay, so 5 ko follow karta hua. So, 4, 5, 1 ek order hai and 2, 3 ek order hai. Okay, so 2, 3 ab blocks start mein aega ki baad mein aega. So, it has to come in the beginning because it's setting the tone. 2 3 4 5 1, ठीक है. सो दैट इज गोइंग टू बी माई ऑर्डर फॉर दिस. कहाँ गया. नाउ द लास्ट वन एंड इट्स टू लेस. द टाइम इज टू लेस बट लेट्स सी, ठीक है. फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ पर्सनल डिसऑर्गेनाइज द एम्प्लॉयमेंट फेज फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू एम्प्लॉयमेंट अफेक्ट्स एन इंडिविजुअल फैमिली एज वेल एज सोसाइटी और इट मे बी सेड दैट एम्प्लॉयमेंट causes personal disorganization, family disorder. Okay, let's just 3 4 2 1, let's take a risk over here. Theta I वैसे maybe here 3 2 4 1 5 2, 3, 4, फाइन, रिलैक्स करेंगे. बाकी सारे तो हमने अच्छे से किया है. वी वर अनश्योर अबाउट 3 ऑफ द क्वेश्चन ओवर हियर, बाकी VA हमने अच्छे से सॉल्व किया है काफी. ठीक है, इट्स फाइन. लास्ट वन के लिए इतना फाइट नहीं मारा बिकॉज 5 सेंटेंसेस थे. दैट्स वाई वी वर प्लेइंग इट स्मार्टर एंड वी प्रायोरिटाइज द 4 क्वेश्चन वाला. आई जस्ट शो यू ऑल वॉट माई स्कोर इज. लेट्स सी, आई ट्राई टू मेंटेन द एक्यूरेसी. ठीक है, सो ही जाएगा. आई हैव लेफ्ट अ बंच ऑफ क्वेश्चंस आल्सो, सो दैट शुड बी गुड. ओ एंड पीजे वर रिलेटिवली सिंपल दिस टाइम. ओके, फोर इज एट 63 एट दिस इज द एक्यूरेसी. सो दिस इज ऑलवेज ओनली वॉट आई चेक. ओके, फर्दर वॉट यू कैन सी इज आई हैव अटेम्प्टेड 22 आउट ऑफ 25. ओके, सो रीड करना एंड हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू प्रोसेस द इन्फॉर्मेशन इज डेफिनेटली ऑफ अटमोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंस ओवर हियर. ठीक है, लेट्स जस्ट सी विच वन इज इनकरेक्ट. टॉपिक वाइज, डिफिकल्टी वाइज, क्वेश्चन वाइज. कुछ हो ना हो, VARC इज डेफिनेटली समथिंग दैट आई स्टिल एंजॉय गिविंग. सो यस, फॉर श्योर. ओके, अच्छा तो इधर तो नहीं दिखा रहे हैं. ओ दे 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 दे, वी हैव. ओके, लास्ट वन, बेसिकली द लास्ट वन जो जुगाड़ करके हमने कुछ भी डाल दिया था. ठीक है, अदर देन दैट आई थिंक माई डाउट्स वर गुड विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू लीविंग दीज क्वेश्चन बिकॉज दे वर्कड आउट. आई एम ग्लैड. ठीक है, सो 100% एक्यूरेसी इन RC इज समथिंग दैट मेक्स मी हैप्पी ऑल द टाइम एंड दैट इज समथिंग विच इज वेरी मच अचीवेबल, वेरी मच डूएबल. ओके, अदर देन दिस गाइज, आई होप योर प्रेप इज गोइंग वेल. ऑल द बेस्ट एंड टेक केयर, बाय. इफ देर आर एनी थिंग एल्स दैट यू वॉन्ट मी टू इनकॉर्पोरेट इन द वीडियोज, डेफिनेटली लीव इट इन द कॉमेंट. And I am reading, and I am definitely taking note of that. Okay.